Fisheries Minister Shane Jones is reviewing the rollout of cameras on commercial fishing boats. He's promising to cut red tape as the industry raises concerns about costs and privacy.
What we've agreed is that the money spent to date and the rollout of the cameras will not be reversed. However, a review is about to take place so we can work out, in the event there's a further extension of cameras, how's it going to be paid for? Who's going to pay for it, and how can the camera footage be used as a way of enhancing management outcomes?
Yes, while it's alarmed marine experts, they say our monitoring is already poor and any reduction will lead to more dolphin deaths. For more, we're joined by University of Otago marine scientist Professor Liz Slooten. Morena, Professor, thank you so much for your time this morning. What do you make of this review? How concerned are you about it?
What the minister's saying, that the cameras going onto boats is going to continue and it's just a matter of cost. It won't make a whole lot of difference with the monitoring. But it would be really a shame if it was returned or reversed, because we've had some big surprises already. So, for example, the amount of bycatch and trawl nets is much higher than anyone had expected. There have been six in just a few months, when actually MPI think there are, in that same area, only three caught in a whole year. So we're finally getting some real information about how much bycatch is occurring, and it's critical that that work continues.
Yeah, and let's remember that there's only about half of the fleet of commercial fishing vessels that have these cameras on them at the moment, which is, you know, and this is part of the review, is whether that will roll out to the rest. So then talk to me about how important these cameras are on fishing vessels.
So far there's been observers going out on fishing vessels, but the number of boats that have had those observers on has been very low. So far there's only ever been one trawl catch of a Hector's dolphin that's been seen by an observer, and that was in the 1990s. So that tells you something about the level of observer coverage. So putting cameras on makes it possible to monitor a much higher proportion. And as you say, so far the areas where it's been rolled out, it's roughly half the boats. And in some areas, it's a lot worse. So the gillnet fishery off the North Island West Coast has less than 10% coverage, because it includes a lot of very small boats. So we still really don't know how many dolphins are being caught, Maui dolphins, that is, in the North Island West Coast harbours. And there's only 48 of them, so that is critical.
Yeah, we heard from the minister in the introduction, but the concerns from the industry are, well, there's two in particular. One is around privacy and who has access to the vision. The other is around cost. So I want to get your thoughts on both of those. And if we talk about the cost, first of all, the concern is that there's a number of smaller vessels that they say it's just simply not feasible to have these cameras on there, the cost of them, and that the system is actually worth more than the vessel itself. Also, the ongoing monitoring of the cameras, which are done by government agency Fisheries New Zealand. Is there any validity in that argument around cost?
So far, it's my understanding that the government is footing the entire bill, or almost the entire bill, of putting the cameras on the boats. And the industry are being asked to contribute towards funding for the ongoing management, things like, as you say, people watching the video. So that, to me, seems like a massive government subsidy or taxpayer subsidy of the fishing industry. And that would be fine with me if the subsidy was going to be used, for example, to help people transition from fishing methods that kill dolphins to fishing methods that don't. And there are plenty of those. But to be subsidising a fishing method like gill nets, which is incredibly damaging to the environment, to not just dolphins, but seabirds and other species of protected animals, that to me seems to be just the wrong way to go. So if it really is that expensive to monitor these fisheries that are doing all this damage to our marine environment, then maybe we need to think about either moving those fishing methods out of dolphin habitat properly, and then you wouldn't have to do so much monitoring, or transitioning to selective sustainable fishing methods. And that will benefit the fishing industry itself. Right. So at the moment, they are mining dolphins and mining fish resources in an unsustainable sort of short-sighted way. And it would be brilliant if they looked at sort of the 30-year plan rather than the 3-year plan.
What about the argument that this potentially could breach privacy? And also who has access to that vision. If I can quote Jeremy Helson, who's from Seafood NZCE, this was his quote from the story ran on 6pm last night. Cameras in private workplaces is not something we have in New Zealand, and to impose that on the seafood industry is a conversation that needs to be had. How do you respond to that?
Well, I'm sure truck drivers might not be so keen on trucking companies monitoring their vehicle speeds, how long they take a break for lunch, etc. But this has led to huge improvements in road safety. Likewise, I'm not too keen on speed cameras. I've been caught foul of them on a number of occasions. But I'm pleased there is a speed limit and there are people keeping an eye out, because otherwise it would be just dangerous to get into your car. And then there's cameras in supermarkets, same, I'm not too keen, but, you know, you accept it. And so in this case, it really is just the cost of doing business. This is a public resource. These fish belong to all of us. And these dolphins and seabirds and whales and so on certainly do. So really it's either cameras or observers. And, you know, you could argue that if the fishermen had reported all of the hundreds of dolphins they've caught over the years, then if they'd been honest all of that time, then maybe we wouldn't need cameras now. But the reporting rate has been about 1%, the self-reporting rate. And we don't know what it is now, because it will all depend on the number of boats that have cameras on, the proportion of that footage that anybody is looking at, how many dolphins drop out of the net before it comes into view of the cameras. So all of that will need to be worked out, and that will require observers alongside cameras, at least for a year or two, until we've got those things sorted out.
Professor Liz Slooten joining us from the University of Otago this morning. We appreciate you being with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you.